Wouldn't it be amazing if you could have an expert sitting right next to you anytime you want to learn some new software? Someone you can ask questions, get instant answers, and simply learn by doing. Well, now you can. And the best part? It doesn't cost anything. Basically, you don't need me anymore. Although, I like to think that we had a good thing going. Let's dive in. To get started, head to the Google AI Studio website and then sign in with your Google account. If you've never heard of Google AI Studio before, it's primarily designed as a development platform where you can create, train, and deploy custom AI solutions that use Google AI technologies. Now, you might be thinking, you don't do that, but as a user, you can still experiment with the tech, and that's what we're going to do. Feel free to follow along. Once you finish signing in, you'll land here in the main interface. Over on the left-hand side navigation, let's click on the option that says Stream Real Time. So what is Stream Real Time? Well, over here, it tells us that you can start interacting in real time using text, voice, video, or screen sharing. But what does that mean? It basically means that you can show the AI what you're working on, and then you'll get instant feedback from the AI. This is especially helpful if you're trying to learn new software where you really want that interactive feedback. Down at the very bottom, we can click on this icon so the AI can hear your microphone. I'll click on this and then we have to allow it in the browser. I'll click here. The AI can now hear me. Down below, we can also turn it on so the AI can see what we're working on. When I click on this, you can share your camera or your screen. In this case, I want to share my screen, so I'll click on this option. Then I'll get a prompt where I can select what I would like to share with the AI. In the top right-hand corner, I'll click on my entire screen, and here, let me select screen number 2, and then click on share. Hey, can you hear me okay?
Yes, I can hear you.
Fantastic. I need some help with different apps today. Do you think you could do that?
I can try my best to help you with different apps. What do you need help with, specifically?
I'm in Microsoft Excel now. Can you see my spreadsheet?
Yes, I can see your spreadsheet. It looks like it has columns for date, units sold, product, and location. What do you need help with in Excel?
Yeah, so I have the product and location in one column, but I would prefer to have two separate columns. How do I do that?
Okay, you want to separate the product and location data into two different columns. To do this, you can use the text-to-columns feature in Excel. First, select the column that contains both the product and location data, which is column C. Then, go to the Data tab on the ribbon and find Text to Columns. In the wizard, you'll select Delimited, since there's a comma that separates.
Oh, am I in the right place right now?
Yes, you're in the right place. Okay, the Text to Columns wizard.
Okay, so I have Delimited selected, then what?
Okay, with Delimited selected, you can now click Next in the Text to Columns wizard.
Okay. And then what do I want to use as the delimiter?
The delimiter in this case is a comma and a space. Select the other checkbox, type a comma, then a space in the box, then click Next.
Okay, so I've selected comma, I'll select Next.
Okay, now you can click Next.
Okay, I'm going to click on Finish.
All right, click on Finish.
Oh, and it looks like I now have a new column with the location. Perfect.
Great, you have successfully separated the product and location into two different columns using the Text to Columns feature. Is there anything else I can assist you with in Excel?
Yeah, I'd like to see the units sold by location. How do I do that?
You can use a pivot table to see the units sold by location. First, select all of your data, including headers. Then go to the Insert tab on the ribbon and click on Pivot Table. In the window that appears, click OK to create a pivot table on a new sheet. Then, in the pivot table builder
on
the right...
Okay, so I have my new sheet, I have my pivot table. What do I do here?
Okay, now in the Pivot Table Fields pane, you should drag Location to the Rows area and Units Sold to the Values area. This will show you the total units sold for each location in your pivot table.
Nice. And what would I use columns for? What's that for?
The Columns area is used to break down the data further. For example, if you drag the Product field to the Columns area, you'll see a breakdown of how many units of each product were sold in each location. This is useful for comparing how different products perform across different locations.
Any interesting insights here, or anything that I should call out to my manager?
Looking at your pivot table, it seems that oatmeal raisin is your top-selling product with 23,282 units sold overall, while snickerdoodle is your lowest seller at 18,452 units. Also,
just a quick point here. It looks like chocolate chip is actually more. Are you sure that oatmeal raisin is the best?
You are absolutely correct. My apologies. Chocolate chip is actually the top seller, with 23,614 units sold, followed by Oatmeal Raisin with 23,282. Snickerdoodle is still the lowest seller at 18,452. Is there anything else you'd like to explore in the pivot table?
Let's now look at how AI Studio can help us in another application, DaVinci Resolve. If you've never heard of this before, it's free video editing software that I personally use to edit all the videos on my channel. If you want an in-depth tutorial, check out the video down below in the description. I have this clip on my timeline, and I want to zoom in on this clip from the very beginning right up until the end of my clip. How do I go about doing that?
Okay, you want to zoom in on a clip in DaVinci Resolve. Starting from the beginning and continuing to the end of the clip, I can help with that. First, select the clip on your timeline. Then go to the inspector panel. In the inspector panel—
Oh, hold on a second. Where's the inspector panel?
Okay, you're looking for the inspector panel in DaVinci Resolve. Mm-hmm. It's usually located on the upper right side of the screen, near the media pool and mixer panels. Do you see it there?
I see inspector. Yep, I clicked on it. Okay, so how do I slowly zoom in on this clip?
Now that you've selected the clip and opened the inspector panel, look for the transform section where you'll see a zoom parameter. You can animate it by creating keyframes. Do you see that zoom setting?
I see the zoom setting, so I'm at the beginning of the clip. What do I do with the zoom setting?
With the playhead at the beginning of the clip, click the diamond-shaped keyframe icon next to the zoom parameter. This will set the starting zoom level. What zoom level would you like for the beginning of the clip?
I'll just start with one, just the standard zoom.
Okay, so the zoom is set to 1 at the beginning of the clip. Now move the playhead to the end of the clip. And what zoom level do you want at the end?
Let's say maybe 1.2 or 1.3. Maybe something like that.
Okay, let's set the zoom to 1.24 at the end of the clip. You should now see a keyframe icon appear at the end. Now the zoom will transition smoothly from 1 to 1.24 across the entire clip. Is that the effect you were aiming for?
Oh, look at that. Thanks for the help. That's awesome. Hi, I'm in PowerPoint and I'm pulling together a presentation. Can you see this slide on my screen?
Yes, I can see your PowerPoint slide. It's titled Future Plans and mentions opening 100 more retail locations for the Kevin Cookie Company next year. Is there anything specific you'd like to discuss about it?
Yeah, we're a fast-growing company. We're opening up a lot of locations. The one thing is I look at this slide here and it doesn't feel that inspiring. I feel like I could make this better. Any recommendations?
Okay, you feel the future plan slide could be more inspiring, and you're looking for recommendations. Is that correct?
That's right.
All right, one way to make this slide more inspiring could be to add some visuals. Perhaps a map showing where these 100 new locations might be. Or maybe a collage of images showcasing happy customers enjoying the cookies. What do you think about these suggestions?
Yeah, that's a good idea. How would I insert a map in here?
To insert a map, you could use the Insert tab in PowerPoint. Then, select Pictures or Online Pictures to find a map image. Alternatively,
okay, hold on a second. I'm here in Online Pictures. What should I search for?
Since you're talking about new retail locations, you could search for a map of the region or country you plan to expand in. Alternatively, if you want to focus on...
Just to jump in here, we're planning on opening stores throughout the world, so maybe I just type in Map of World?
Okay, a map of the world sounds good, given your plans. Do you want to search for a specific type of map, like a political map or a physical map, or just any map of the world?
What do you think of these options? Which one do you think would work well?
Out of the options shown, the one in the top left corner and the one in the top middle seem like good choices. They both have a clear and easy to read design, and they show all the countries of the world. Would you like to try one of those?
Yeah, let me try this. Let's try inserting that on the slide. Okay, ooh, that's big.
Yes, the map is quite large. You can resize it by clicking and dragging the corners or edges of the image. Would you like me to walk you through that, or do you have any other ideas for the slide?
No, I think I'm good. This tech is a fantastic example of the positive benefits of AI. You can now learn at your own pace, on your own terms. But one thing to be cautious of, the AI sees everything on your screen. If you're working with confidential content, just be mindful of what you share. According to Google, with the free plan, your data may be used to improve their product, which likely means that they're using it to train models. So if you're learning something basic, that's fine. Just don't go sharing your company's financials. That would be bad. One feature that I think could take this to the next level is if it could do screen annotation. Imagine the AI could draw a box or point where to click, or even just do the task for you while showing you how it's done. That would be amazing. Just relying on the verbal instructions can sometimes be a little bit tricky to know where exactly to go. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments. Do you think you'll be using this? Now, I hope to see you in the next video. That is, of course, unless AI answers the question first.